Welcome back to my channel. In this session we will see how we can test the drive signal of a PWM controller IC. It is a question from my viewer. He asked me that, Assalamu alaikum, how we can test a drive signal of any power supply without DSO, without any oscilloscope. To test a drive signal for any IC, first of all, go to its datasheet, its pin out. For that purpose, I shared in my last video that you can use component layout, this application in your mobile, and type the number of this IC. Here it is using TL494. If you don't know about the pin out, just only check where is the output. So here is E1, E2, emitter number 1, emitter number 2, collector number 1 and collector number 2. In TL494 or KA7500, if emitter is grounded, the drive signal will from the collector pin. If the collector is supplied with positive voltage, at that time we will receive the drive signal from pin number 10 and 9. Now we will check. To test drive signal, I am using this Unity 202A+. Connect one pin to the ground. Now set to DC voltage. Connected pin number 9, 10. So it is giving 1.4 volt. That means it is 0 volt. If we check between the ground, it is 1.4 volt. That means it is ground pin. So we will check drive signal at pin number 11. It is 34 kilohertz. Pin number 11, that is 34 kilohertz. And pin number 8, 34 kilohertz. So it is switching at 34 kilohertz. So in this way we can verify the frequency of any IC. If it is switching, it will give the frequency. If it is not giving the frequency, at that time we need to check the voltage. DC voltage at pin number 14. Here must be 5 volt. Pin number 12 is supply voltage. It is 16 volt. 16 volt available, then we need 4.9 volt, that is 5 volt, that is reference voltage. It must generate 5 volt reference, and then we must verify pin number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It must be 0. If it is pulled up 3 volt, 2 volt, 5 volt, at that time this TL494 or KA7500 will off. So in this way we can verify the switching of this IC. Now we will check the other IC, that is OB2269. I will connect to ground. This is the ground terminal and we will connect to this drive resistor, that is output of pin number 8. This OB2269, its pin number 8 is drive signal. So it is 1.9 kilohertz with no load. It is switching at 1.95 kilohertz. I will use now this multimeter. AC millivolt, hertz. Connect this pin to ground terminal. It is 1.9 kilohertz. 1.8587 kilohertz. So in this way we can verify the switching, either the IC is switching or not. The second thing we can also verify from this VCC capacitor, DC voltage across this capacitor. That is here, If we have voltage here, it is 15.5 volt, that means the auxiliary winding, the VCC section, is working and it is providing voltage at this capacitor. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.